decide what to record, what's not, and I stop transcription. Okay. Hello. Good. Yeah, and then I start my slides. Hopefully the participants will come later after to the could enter, I hope, because the, I will be not able to see the participants or chat or anything, just my slides. Okay, that is my slides. Okay. Yeah. Now.
Fine. Okay.
Can you? Okay. Thank you. So this is the seminar, and this semester it's the second seminar when where our speakers are from the School of Mathematics. And the first seminar was done by Mark Kuker. It was in October, as I remember. And now this is another seminar, so it would be reasonable to perform it as well in our library or tea room. However, before deciding what to do with the seminar, I noticed that I should take a booster on Saturday, and to be on safe side, I decided to do this online, and this was way right, because I'm still having some side effects after that booster. So, but I'm okay to speak online. So the my presentation today is about three-dimensional and violent hydroelasticity. Three-dimensional means, three-dimensional, and violent means the events, interactions of short duration, this like impact. And hydroelasticity means that there is the elastic body and the liquid. So, and they are interacting one with another. So the in particular, this is related to ice and impact on ice, or using the lifeboat in ice. Another application is okay, application or quite a recent, it was published 2 years ago, it's American researchers, they published several papers. It's about elastometric sphere, elastic sphere, skipping on water, and that is very much related to projects Mark Kuker supervised several years in our school. It's about duck and drake game. So that is the it's much more complicated situation as that Mark suggested to our undergraduate students, because now the that sphere it's shown over here is elastic, and because of elasticity, it changes shape, and it's keeping occur very differently. And by the way, because this is my presentation is part of a series of seminars dedicated to Mark Kuker, so I should say that Mark is the first, say, as we say now, young researcher I met in the UK more than 30 years ago. So the first I met John Orkindon and Howell Peregrine, it was the September 1990 in Cambridge, it was the conference. Frank, I don't remember, have you been there at that conference in Magdalen College? I'm not sure. Next I met Sam Hovison and Mark Kuker in Bristol. And after that, we met several times at a different conference. It's like 1996, we met in Hamburg. And that time, Simon Cox presented his PhD, part of his PhD, as I remember. So, and after 2007, we worked with Mark on several projects, including and hydroelasticity impacts and other stories. So that hydroelasticity is a complicated issue on its own, and mainly it was solved or described in a two-dimensional setting. It's like for elastic wedge entering water or elastic plate impacting on a wave or wave impacting on the elastic plate. Different situation with impact at several points, impact with trapped cavity. So many things were solved, but it's always in two-dimensional. And it was solved by, mainly, it was solved by a so-called normal mode method. It means that we calculated the normal modes or so-called eigenvibrations of a dry beam, or the dry beam in two-dimensional, in three-dimensional, it should be dry plate. And we decompose the axial deflection as a superposition of these dry modes. We also we used a finite element model combined with Wagner theory. It was for wedge, but after that we didn't work on it. So the only paper it's in 2006. So the two-dimensional problems of hydroelasticity are well developed. As to say dimensional, they are much less known how to do that. And actually, the only paper I know about say dimensional hydroelasticity is by Yves-Marie Scolan in 2004. Yves-Marie solved the problem of elastic cone impact on water. So it's an axisymmetrical problem with elastic structure. Then later, with Richard Purvis and Mike Pegg, we work as part of Mike's dissertation. We work on impact of liquid droplet on small elastic plate mounted in rigid otherwise substrate. So that problem is quite similar to the problem studied by Yves-Marie Scolan, just the different edge condition for the plate and different geometry. But also in this problem, we found so-called new mechanism for splashing caused by elastic vibration of this plate. So the hydroelasticity and violent hydroelasticity, hydroelasticity of short duration. They are, you can meet it in many applications. It's like the water entry problem, then catamaran in waves, slamming of ships, wave breaking waves or not breaking waves, impact on structure, then ice sheets, floating ice, and impact on it, the performance of lifeboats in the ice field. Also, here I will be concentrated on this problem. So it's impact on floating plate, elastic plate, with a rigid body, and there is a layer between them. I will explain this layer. And that is the to break ice or to survive on ice, for example, to use ice as the runaway. And that is the in New Hampshire. The So there is different applications of short time interaction between floating ice, floating plates, and something impacting on it. So there are applications, but my presentation will be about mathematical issues of three-dimensional hydroelastic problems. So in this formulation, we consider actually viscoelastic plate, okay, in general, it's viscoelastic plate of a certain shape floating on water surface and a rigid body impacting this plate at a certain point. This problem is not axisymmetrical, it's anything. Analysis will be first presented in general form for any shape, any shape of the plate. However, it's for general shape, it's difficult to proceed. But still, we did some simplifications of this analysis, and it will be presented. And kind of deeper understanding we got with a circular plate. So this plate is circular, but impact is not at the center, so it's still three-dimensional. However, you can imagine that for a circular plate, you can separate the angular coordinates, so you can reduce dimension of the problem, but it still will be a complicated three-dimensional problem, it's complicated because it's a so-called mixed boundary value problem. The normal derivative is for liquid, normal derivative is given on the plate, and the function itself, potential, is given, presented on the free surface outside the plate. There is also one difficulty which I will explain, but we did it already for two-dimensional problem. It's about the cover of that viscoelastic plate. We assume that the plate is covered with thin viscoelastic something different material, and that different material helps us to formulate so-called impact model. In our problem, we do not assume impact loads, but we calculate them. Four parts are in this problem to be solved. So this is coupled problem. We need to find deflection of the plate. Then we need a deflection of the plate. Then we need to find motion of the rigid body during the interaction. It can be given or could be not. And then flow caused by the plate deflection. And also we need to find impact loads, which depends on the rigid body motion and the plate deflection. To do this, we introduce, as I told you, the thin layer, which is described by nonlinear and one-dimensional Winkler-Kelvin-Voigt model. So actually, this means that this layer is modeled by many one-dimensional springs, which are acting independently of each other. It's in this way we can model the impact loads and calculate the impact loads, and I will explain why without this layer it would be complicated to do this. Also, reaction force of this layer is non-dimensional, but if we assume it's linear, means that the penetration depth of the body in this layer is small, then the problem can be simplified, and also problem can be simplified if the region of contact, this region, is small compared with the size of the body and size of the plate So the that layer, I call it soft layer on the upper surface, it's can be described in one dimensional case by Hooke's law, means that penetration depth H is proportional to reaction force sigma. And then if we combine all the coefficients into one, we arrive at this formula where the reaction force is just proportional to the linear proportional to the penetration depth. The formula can be generalized in different way. So we can make it nonlinear, it will be done. And also we can include dissipation. Dissipation means that we introduce retardation time tau, and the we write relation between penetration depth into the layer and the reaction force in a little bit more complicated form. It was found that dissipation changed significantly the impact load. So it's interestingly that dissipation increases the impact loads, but not decreases them. So this is the difference between violent hydroelasticity when everything occurs in short time and say normal hydroelasticity, it's about waves propagating in floating elastic plate when the dissipation dumped all disturbances. So the if you consider events of short duration, then the hydrodynamic part of the problem can be simplified, means that all equations of flow and boundary conditions can be linearized, and boundary conditions can be imposed at the initial level of liquid, including the body boundary condition, on the plate. So in this presentation, I will not show any numerical results. So this is only about mathematical part. And the presentation will be focused on evaluation of impact loads, how to find them, and the edit mathematics for floating, but it's only circular elastic plate. Even for circular elastic plate, it seems that it's a new edit mathematics, and it will be explained what's that and how to find it. The three-dimensional problem is complicated, in particular because we need many modes. If we decompose the modes in, say, even for circular plate, in radial direction and in azimuthal direction, then my estimate shows that we need to take about 60 terms in azimuthal direction and about 100 terms in radial direction. So it's already give 6,000 eigenmodes to be used. Okay, it could be less, but kind of in general case, it's quite a lot of modes we need to keep in three-dimensional case compared to the two-dimensional. Maximum number of modes in two-dimensional case, it was 100. So we didn't use more. If the plate, a two-dimensional plate, is of constant thickness without any internal support, then normally, usually 20 modes, 15 modes is okay. But three-dimensional problem is different. In this case, in three-dimensional problems, we need many modes. So then you can imagine that once we solve, we need to solve many equations. And actually, if we keep 6,000 modes, then we got 12,000 first order nonlinear differential equations to be solved. And that is quite complicated because at each time we need to update the impact loads at least. And this is only for if the plate is floating. If the if we consider the problem of elastic body, the three-dimensional elastic body penetrating the liquid, then we need update the edit mathematics as well at each time step because the weighted air is changing with time. So that is the reason why we concentrate on some mathematical details on this formulation to be able to solve the problem by normal mode method. So that is the about this slide shows formulation two-dimensional problem. So H it's not well, it's a thickness of ice, thickness of floating plate, and HE is the thickness of that elastic or soft layer on the surface of floating plate, and that is the rigid body. So it goes down with penetration, with displacement of the body S of T. F of X describes the shape of the body. The first interesting point and why we need this elastic layer is that if there are no such layer, then the loads are point loads. So that is a little bit it's unusual, because we expect that there are proper contact between elastic plate and rigid body, but actually it's not. And to show this, we considered a very simple problem. It's a static problem of infinite two-dimensional problem, infinite plate on water surface, and we placed a circular cylinder on this plate. And initially, mass of the cylinder is zero. So then you can think that the contact definitely in one point is over here. Right? And after that, we increase the mass, and we search, we find the deflection of the plate, and we find that it's still at one, the contact is still at one point, because the curvature of the ice or curvature of the that elastic plate, it's smaller than the curvature of the circle of the circular cylinder. And finally, if we increase, but we when we it's a, it's already very large weight of the body, so the displacement of the body is very large. So we would expect that finally it come to that single point. It give rise to a non-zero contact interval, but actually it's not. Instead of this, its contact will happen at two points, one over here and another one over there. So more details of this contact point are shown over here. So the points are always, loads are always point loads. So there is the, we increase the mass, and the contact is always at this point. And after that, the contact point starts to move from the center depending on the mass. Okay. So this is why the introducing this soft layer, it's play several roles. Mathematically, it can be considered as the penalty method or regularization method to avoid point loads. But also, it can be considered as there is physical sense, physical meaning of this layer, because it can be it can model snow on the surface of ice, snow which is more kind of flexible, not flexible, more elastic, more soft than the ice itself. It can model a layer of crushed ice, but this is more complicated, because in this case the soft layer should be allowed to increase its thickness or increase its thickness, so the mass of ice can be allowed to go to the soft layer. So the this formulation, that formulation will be used to solve a problem for floating rigid plate. So that is impact on the rigid plate, and in this case we write the equation for body motion. So it's a second Newton law, where this is the mass of the body, this is gravity force, and that is the impact force. Impact force, as I told you, it's given by this formula. By the way, here in the case of it's alpha is the force, so alpha is not one, it can be like say over two, for example, in three dimensional problem of sphere impact on plate. This is two dimensional problem. Then floating rigid plate motion is described by this equation. Again, this part, it's mass of plate, impact load, it's understandable. All other terms come from hydrodynamics. So that that is terms with added mass of the plate, and this is the nonlinear terms which come from the paper by EFRT. It's an asymptotic analysis of small motion of floating plate with time. And then equations for plate indentation are shown over here. This problem was solved by our technique, normal modes, and this is the red lines. It's about theory, normal mode method. And this it was solved also by CFD, by Kevin Mackey and his student Chen. And you can see the results are almost perfect. So this means that the model is not so bad. And to finishing the two-dimensional problems, I explain about nonlinear reaction force. Modify the reaction force by introducing function g, where delta is a relative compression of the elastic layer. So he is initial thickness and h is the penetration depth into elastic layer, and delta is relative compression of the elastic. So this is the quantity participating in the Hooke's law, but in the Hooke's law, the force is proportional delta in linear Hooke's law. So, but we tried to avoid contact of the body with the rigid plate, saying that if the body approach close to the rigid plate, means that the soft layer thickness becomes very small, then the reaction force increase significantly. So that is more or less standard analysis, because the relation between stresses and strains it's not linear, it's general, but the function simplified here. It's was done only for mathematical solving problems, say. If you include this function from relation stress strain relation for particular material, then it will describe the real behavior of this soft layer. So then the equation of the plate deflection is the beam equation, or equation of cylindrical bending of thin elastic plate. Viscoelastic effects of the plates are described by this coefficient, which is called retardation time. This is the damping. That is the hydrodynamic force. As I said, the hydrodynamic problem can be simplified because the deflections are small, displacement of liquid are small, so we can linearize Bernoulli equation just saying that the pressure is equal to minus rho and derivative of velocity potential in time. This is the hydrostatic force, hydrostatic pressure. Normally it's neglected, or at least we showed that it gives a little contribution, and this is the impact force. So then I'll show you some results for two-dimensional case. Some of them were shown by Tatiana at two conferences we did, we participated this month. They are kind of relevant, these slides, to the to this presentation. In particular, we can solve asymmetric impact, and even you can see there is the contact. It seems that contact, the blue line is for rigid body, it's parabolic with a radius of curvature 5 meters. And red line is for shape of the plate. But actually there are no contact. I will show you later. No direct contact of ice and rigid plate. You see the deflection looks too big here. But actually, if you pay attention to the scale of vertical axis compared to the horizontal axis, you can find that the slopes of the plate are small, and this is why the elastic model of the plate can be used. So here, in last figure, the impact is almost at the edge. Now, recently we did impact on the plate with the crack, so the crack like this, and length of the crack is length of the crack is say 70% here, 70% of the plate thickness, and position of the crack is 0.2. So 0.2 from the center of the plate. So you see what's happening here. This is the deflection of the plate. So the crack, what it's doing, it's in some sense, plate with crack is kind of like two rigid plates connected with the torsional spring. So you can see like the deflection of the plate looks like straight lines over here. But what's interesting that this is the contact region, but the contact region of the rigid body with the elastic layer, and you can see that it's quite complicated, and it would be difficult to imagine the shape without without calculation. And if we make the crack shorter, so it's a 50% of thickness, but it's at the center, so just over here. So you can see that finally the plate still separate from the body, because here rigid body, parabolic body, just moving down at constant speed, 1 meter per second. But after impact, the plate, floating plate, starts to vibrate, and it's separate from the body. And the contact region looks like this. So initially, it's increases. So this is the coordinate along the plate, and this is the time. So at each time instant, you can see over here the contact region is there, but then the plate will separate at the center, and finally the plate separate from the body completely. Okay. So that is the kind of introduction, long introduction. So now we go to three-dimensional problems, and as I said, the difficulty is to avoid calculating of elements of the problem at each time instant. So let's impact the curl at x0, y0 over here, and we introduce two system of coordinates, red local system, and x and y black, it's a global system. And there is the edge of the plate, and this is blue line is for boundary of the contact region. Notice that the x and y, they can be selected differently, but for our purpose, it's convenient to select them in such a way that these three integrals are zero. So the orientation of x and y is not arbitrary for this case. Then the plate deflection is described by a two-dimensional equation of the plate. W is function of x, y, and t, and dp is the rigidity of the plate, mp is the mass of the plate per unit length. PH is the hydrodynamic pressure, and PI is the impact loads. So the plate is with free edge, means there is no support at the edge, and this is modeled by these two complicated conditions with the derivative of second and third order. Initially, the plate is at rest. Then the full problem is shown over here. So this part is plate deflection, and plate deflection depends on hydrodynamic loads and also on the impact loads. Then hydrodynamic loads are obtained from the solution of the hydrodynamic problem, where phi is the velocity potential and the hydrodynamic pressure is given by linearized Bernoulli equation. The big D is the area of the plate. And DC is the area of the contact between rigid body and the soft layer. So on the plate, the body boundary condition is given. So normal vertical velocity of the plate is equal to vertical velocity of water on that plate, and on the free surface, the potential is equal to zero, which comes from that linearized Bernoulli equation. The dynamic boundary condition is saying that hydrodynamic pressure is zero on the water surface, and then we define dt is zero, and then we integrate it in time to get that phi equal to zero. So this is a problem, is a mixed boundary value problem, where the potential is given outside the plate and normal derivative is given on the plate, and we need to solve the Laplace equation. So there are, I don't think there are any general solutions or general results about this problem. Then the impact load is described by this equation, where delta, as I said, is the relative compression of the elastic layer, and H, penetration depth, depends on the shape of the body, where now shape of the body describes a function of two variables, x and y. S of t is vertical displacement of the body, and w is the deflection of the plate. So you see that impact loads are calculated in complicated way, and all these problems are connected between each other. And if you write force problem for the motion of the rigid body like this, so you can see there are four problems which are coupled. All of them should be solved at the same time. So the to solve this problem in general, so we introduce the eigenfunctions psi n, where x and y belong to the plate. So this function, this eigen mode depends on the shape of the plate, and they satisfy this boundary differential equation, partial differential equation, and also the edge conditions, which come from the edge conditions from this edge condition. So they are just the same. And this mode should be they are orthogonal, and they are normalized as by one, and this is the integrals, double integrals. So then the deflection of the plate can be decomposed as a proposition, and for an is once we substitute this decomposition into our equation and then project it on the each mode, we arrive at the system of ordinary differential equation for the coefficients or principal coordinates of the modes. And this is fine. So this is the terms from the equation, from the plate equation. The complications come from the right hand side. It's from hydrodynamic loads, that one. And because we need to find the velocity potential and then find this double integral. And also the from impact loads, because the at each time step we need to calculate this double integral. So double integrals and ordinary integrals, it's a very big difference. And as I said, number of modes for required in three-dimensional problems is much higher than in two-dimensional problems. So now, as to the hydrodynamic part, as to phi. So the as to the hydrodynamic part, this is the equation for the velocity potential, phi. And if W is given by superposition of the modes, then we can conclude the potential also can be decomposed in this way, where phi m is the solution of this mixed boundary value problem, and this phi m are independent already on any dynamics. They are depends only on the shape of the plate. So far, it's not a second plate, only on the shape of the plate. So once we solve this problem for phi m, actually it's very complicated, then we can substitute this phi into the first integral, and it gives rise to the integrals like this, which are make edit mass matrix. So that is the symmetric matrix, and the equation of the plate all together is formulated as the matrix system for coefficients for in the plate deflection A. So again, this part with MP is from plate equation. This part also from a plate equation. That big S is the edit mass matrix. So it's quite complicated. Generally, it's I believe it's altogether it's not double integral. It's three double integrals participate over here, and the right hand side also, which is about the which is related to the impact loads and then initial condition. So potentially, if you know the edit mass matrix, by the way, as I said, you told you edit mass matrix, these functions phi m, and that means that edit mass matrix as well, they are independent of any dynamics in the problem. They depend only elements. These elements depend only on the shape of the plate. So this function can be determined and precomputed, which is good. Then, in addition to elastic modes, there are three rigid modes. And rigid modes, they are, in our case, when we selected X and Y proper, they are given three rigid modes, they are over here. And but this simple shape is only under these simple conditions. And the one mode is the hip motion, just up and down. One mode is pitch motion in y direction, and this one in y direction. So then we are concerned. We will return to edit mass matrix, but already for the circular plane. But now we continue still with general, with any arbitrary shape of the body, and we are concerned with this integral over here. And we introduce three simplifications. First of all, we assume that the penetration depth is small in the layer, so a layer is more or less rigid. Then we can use the Hooke's law for reaction force of the layer. Then we introduce, we assume that the body is a paraboloid of rotation. And we assume that during the impact, the deflection of the plate is small and can be neglected. And then after that, these elements is reduced to the double integral of over the region where the compression is positive. Okay, negative compression means that the body is at certain distance from the soft layer, it's not in contact with it, and projected this projected on the modes. The okay, then the contact region in that conditions is circular. And with radius of circle, which depends on the penetration depth, the displacement of the body only. And now we can use the Green's second identity to calculate this integral. You see what's happening, how it's happening. So this psi n we substitute by using this relation. Okay, and the delta plus is this expression where f is shape of the entering body, and this is the penetration displacement of the body. And now integral is only over the region where this expression is positive. So on the border of this region, this expression in a square bracket is zero. Then this psi n we change for the biharmonic operator or psi n, that one. And then we use the Green identity for the first time, moving one Laplacian to the shape. And because the S is independent of X and Y, and the shape of the body is a quadratic function of X and Y, this Laplacian is constant. Okay, this Laplacian is constant. And in addition, So this is the double integral, and also there will be two linear integrals over the border of the contact region. One of them is this one. However, it's equal to zero because on the border of contact region, this expression is zero. And then the second one, which is not zero, and this is normal derivative on the border, and we can calculate it. Oh, okay, we got that one. Now we can use the second identity once again. And finally, we reduce the calculation of the impact loads to the singular integrals, where the normal derivative and Laplacian, they can be calculated for the modes. So then generalization, I told you that this parabolic of rotation, but actually it can be elliptic paraboloid. And elliptic paraboloid is the case of general shape of a smooth body, because we assume that the size of the contact region is small. Then actually here we can account, we can include the dependence of the forces on the deflection of the plate, but only at one point, which is initial point of the impact. And then it's shown that this all these integrals, they are depends on function s only, displacement of the body. So we can pre-calculate these integrals. Okay, there are many of them, but we can pre-calculate them, and to use changing s for s minus w. So then in this way we pre-calculate the integrals, and we do not need to calculate the impact load at each time of integration. And now it's about circular plate. I have say 5-10 minutes. The rest of the presentation will be on about added mass for elastic circular plate floating on water of infinite depth of the circular plate. And as to circular dry plate, there are not many papers, but the study was started more than 100 years ago by early proceedings of Physical Society of London. And then in the 30s, it was the analysis was further developed, and the tables of normal modes and natural frequencies were published in 1979. So this is the, it's not paper, it's tables. The floating circular plates was the studied recently by Sturva and Mellon, and Sturva studied periodic pressures acting on the plate, and then a plate on shallow water. In this case, it's unsteady, but shallow water. For shallow water, the hydrodynamic part is very simple. It's simpler. This year, Mike Mellon published paper on time-dependent motion. Floating elastic plate, but he used another technique, and he used so-called vertical eigenfunctions in the region and domain decomposition technique. So for circular elastic plate, we introduce, could be complicated to see what that, we introduce non-dimensional variables, and then the relative compression of the soft layer depends on the steel, on the displacement of rigid body, deflection of the plate, and this is the shape or the shape of the body. Rb is the radius of curvature of the shape, big R is the radius of the circular plate, He is the thickness of soft layer, and other non-dimensional variables are introduced in another reasonable way. So then we are concerned with such integrals where psi n, tilde is for non-dimensional variables. Psi n, the eigenvalues, eigenmodes, solutions of this problem, which are normalized in that way. So the free edge conditions for circular plate, they are a little bit simpler, but still to with second order and third order derivatives. The psi m here, it's this solution of this mixed boundary value problem. Again, mixed boundary. So normal derivative is given in circle on the circular disk, and the potential is equal to zero on the surface of water outside the disk. So the rigid modes are for circular plates are given over here, and for elastic modes are a product of function cosines, depends on theta and functions of r, and that function functions distribution of the normal modes in R. They are expressed through the Bessel function and modified Bessel function, and all elements are calculated, including that dispersion relation. And then we end up with the problem for the velocity potential. Below velocity potential and caused by deflection of the circular plate. So if you now velocity potential also can be decomposed, so the angle coordinate can be separated. It can be separated from the very beginning, by the way. But then these coefficients depends on radial coordinate, on the vertical coordinate only, and the solution of this problem. And once we know this solution, we of mixed boundary problem, we can calculate the added mass matrix. And here I did actually nothing, because the we solve this problem with Yves-Marie Scolan, and it's a three-dimensional theory of water impact. There are no elastic plate, the shape is rigid, and this is impact problem. But the this mixed boundary problem was solved over here, and the solution is presented by these two formulas. So it's written on the plate, only on the plate. This is what we need, only on the plate. It's presented by this integral where psi it depends on the normal derivative through that, that integral. Now, because the shape of the modes, of the dry elastic mode of the plate, they are given by Bessel function, so we can calculate these integrals, and they are, interestingly, they are given also by Bessel function, but spherical Bessel functions now. And by using this formula, substituting this formula into that integral, we into this integral, we into this integral. Yeah, we find that added mass matrix is given by single integral, where the that function are given through the Bessel function as well. And once you multiply all these two, you can see that everything is reduced to integrals of this type, of the products of Bessel functions. All other integrals where the Bessel function is changed for modified Bessel function is obtained from this one, where lambda, this lambda or that lambda, is changed for pure imaginary one. And we can use this formula. So then the we calculated also the interaction between rigid modes and elastic modes of circular plate. They are given like this, and the heave motion, so that is the is known result. So the rigid circular plate on the water surface, added mass is given by this formula in non-dimensional variables, and this is the added mass of the circular plate in pitch motion, and there are no interaction between pitch motion and heave motion. Other elements were calculated as well. So then the as a result, in three-dimensional hydroelastic problems, we pre-calculate added mass matrix, but so far it can be done only for circular plate with analytical formulas, but potentially it can be done for any shape if we solve mixed boundary hydrodynamic problem for Laplace equation, and also we find dry modes for the plates with the complicated, shapes which are more complicated than circular one. For example, I very much expect that we can do this for elliptic plates. Then impact loads for small dimensions of the contact region were calculated, and it's shown that these forces also can be pre-calculated and before the analysis, and used in integration of a large number of differential equations. Finally, so this is the conclusion. Finally, to conclude, I would say another motivation for this study that we've been presenting results for impact on floating plate for several years, could be two, three years already. And from the very beginning, we criticized that actually in the nature there are no such things as two-dimensional problems, and all problems are three-dimensional. So to answer this these critics and to do something, we start doing this analysis. So the next step is to implement everything. Not everything so far was implemented numerically into the codes, and to calculate the impact on the circular plate at least, but it's truly three-dimensional. It's not axisymmetrical, it's not two-dimensional, it's truly three-dimensional problem. So the would be interesting, for example, it's not so complicated, I believe, to do experiments with a circular elastic plate and impacting by a rigid sphere at different locations, and to measure stresses in that plate with changing or not changing the upper surface of this plate. So thank you for your attention. If you have questions, please unmute your microphone and ask. I cannot see participants, and I cannot see chat. So please pick by microphone. Thank you.
Hello, Sasha. I just wanted to say thank you for a very nice talk. I want to leave it open for other people to ask questions.
Yes, can I ask a question, Marco, Sasha?
Yeah.
Well, first I should echo what Mark has just said. It's a wonderful talk, and it's a very, very challenging subject. Well done. In principle, could the method deal with voids trapped between the body and the say the plate?
Yes. Okay. Yes. So this could be combined. Yes. You're right. Yeah. It's different. I believe it's more complicated, but yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. And are they more likely to occur in three dimensions than in two dimensions?
Yeah, but I'm thinking particularly about, say, for example, in experiments, circular floating plate, elastic plate, and cylinder with a flat bottom, say, impacting on that plate. And indeed, it's possible that the air is trapped between these two, and they can change the interaction.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not sure that this effect could be kind of well observed if the for sphere, for example.
Okay.
Because in three-dimensional case, there are more chances for air to escape from the gap in between. But for that, say, cylinder with flat bottom, there could be some effect of this, and it would be interesting to see what that.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, Sasha. That's interesting.
Yeah. Then I stop sharing, and then I can see the speakers. Okay. I can see you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. I can see you now. Hilary.
Yes. Thank you, Kasia. Thank John? You. Yeah. Just following on from what Frank says in a different context. At some point, you had a horizontal velocity for the impactor, right? It was coming at an angle.
Yes.
Now, if you have solid bodies impacting at an angle, you get friction forces, and yes, there's a big literature in solid mechanics about how the contact set can behave when you have friction forces, because you have thermoelasticity and the contact set can have many components, some void and some So that might be something to think about if you're looking at like the seaplane problem, so you've got something coming in at an angle.
Yes. John, even in the very simplified version of your suggestion, when the oblique impact, so the floating plate and the sphere are impacting in a certain angle, and what's happening later with this sphere or with this body. Is it bounce in that direction or in another direction? It depends not only on the motion of the sphere before the impact, but also on the deflection of the plate. Mm. So that is thank you. I didn't think about it, but it's very interesting and could be interesting research.
And there is certainly literature on impact with a Winkler foundation as well.
Yes. I don't remember the name, but I have a book. It's called Contact Mechanics, and there is the And interesting, it was published. We published somewhere one paragraph of discussion about Winkler Foundation, because each year people criticizing that Winkler Foundation, but they again and again return to this formulation, and somebody who investigated why it's so is that the reason is that this model is very simple, and on the other hand, it describes correctly what's happening, not rightly, but incorrect way, and this is why people are returned to this kind of just for illustration in some sense. But if it's thermal effects or for incline, the shear forces, then it's more complicated, but it's also possible to generalize it. But the most benefit from the Winkler Foundation that it's relatively simple and it's easy to understand and
Thank you, that's the idea.
So, any other questions? Alan, do you think it's possible to do experiments on impact on floating plates? I'm asking Alan Tassan.
Yeah, hello, Sasha. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Yeah. I wasn't listening just before because I was interrupted. So, for sure. Without or with snow?
Oh, without. Yeah, I'm thinking, Alan, also, it's not complicated to change, to put a cover on the upper surface of the floating plate. It could be just azine or polymer or something else, right? And as John suggested, it could be oblique impact or normal impact, and it's possible to measure strains in the plate. And actually, this impact on floating plate is not so violent as water entry of elastic bodies. So there could be more better results and more reliable results. Yeah. I don't know, it just came to my mind.
yes. I was wondering, yes, in terms of applications, you mentioned this landing on an ice cover.
Yeah. And also using live boats in icy water.
Yeah, and but a lifeboat would crack the ice cover, no?
Yeah. But before they crack, it's expected the high loads and the boat itself could be cracked. So we need to avoid it. And as it's now, Alan, the using lifeboats in icy water is not allowed.
Okay.
Yeah. So if there is even floating pieces of ice, it's not allowed to use lifeboats.
What I'm thinking is maybe we could do something with a tire or a wheel, which would swing and come and hit a plate on floating on the surface.
There are also the parts which are about, say, violent hydroelasticity, means short duration impact when the loads are high and impacting body could be damaged or plate could be damaged. But also there another problem is kind of long time interaction. It's about, for example, landing of aircraft on the ice. Mm-hmm. This is important, but this is initially its impact, but after that the aircraft is moving on ice, and that is another problem with another effect, and where they say gravity is important, but for impact problem, the gravity is not important. It's not important. So there is different aspects. But breaking, for example, breaking ice or using ice for safe transportation, it could be interesting. Any other? So we are already late, 5 minutes, 6 minutes late. So if there are no any other questions, then thank you very much to all our participants. Thank you very much, and thank you, Mark, for. Nice encouraging words. And, still have two seminars this semester, and one will be next week. It will be done by IFMA Iskolan. It's about flip through, as I understand, and complicated free surface motions. And then Matt Turner will speak in 2 weeks. It will be the last seminar this semester. Okay, thank you very much, all of you. Mark, yes. I hope if my attended today, but I couldn't see him. I couldn't see all participants. So then I stop recording, and this presentation will be saved and uploaded to the. Thank you, Peter. Thank you very much. You are very kind. Uploaded to the our channel. Thank you. Then I close the seminar. And, bye-bye.
Thank you, Sasha.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.